non-specific ST-T wave changes are one of the more common interpretations we see in ECG readings. The changes in the ST segment and T waves are deemed non-specific because they don't fit in any of the other criteria, like the criteria for ischemia, strain pattern, or even the effects of drugs or metabolic abnormalities in the patient. However, there are in fact criteria wherein we read non-specific ST-T wave change. Number one, they are ST segment junction depression of less than 0.5 millimeter or a downsloping ST segment or a T wave nadir, again less than 0.5 millimeter, below the isoelectric baseline in any leads 1, 2, AVL, V2, or V6, meaning that these are the particular leads where these changes are labeled non-specific. If you see these changes in the leads other than 1, 2, AVL, or V2, V6, like for example, AVR, AVF, lead 3, or V1, then they are part of the normal variant and not labeled as non-specific STT wave change. The second criteria is that of an ST segment junction depression, this time more than 1 millimeter, but it is rapidly upsloping or U-shaped in the same leads. Now, this second ECG morphology of the ST segment change should be differentiated from that of the effect of digitalis on the ECG. Now, digitalis would induce J-junction or ST segment junction depression, but it is downsloping, and the following T-wave will be, in fact, most commonly diphasic. Like, for example, in this ECG tracing, the T-wave is initially negative, becoming positive but flattened. And this characteristic, the combination of the ST segment depression and the diphasic T wave with initial negative deflection will produce the scooped appearance, which is quite typical of the digoxin effect in the body. Now, the third criteria for non-specific ST-T wave change will be the presence of a T wave which is flat or diphasic or inverted in leads 1, AVL, V3, or V6 when the R wave is 5 millimeters or more. The prevalence of the subtle repolarization abnormality is quite common. In fact, in a cohort of American individuals, they have been shown to be present in around 8 to 12% of their ECG tracings, more common in women. If you see the subtle repolarization changes, the ST segment depression or the T wave flattening, but they are not associated with any evident cause or specifically with cardiac disease, then they are not clinically significant, meaning that the prognosis of patients is the same as that of patients without it. However, in male individuals who are affected by hypertensive cardiovascular disease, coronary artery disease, or any cardiovascular disease for that matter, the presence of the subtle repolarization abnormalities have been in fact associated with increased mortality in them. So in patients with those diseases, and you see this repolarization changes, the non-specific STT wave change, then you should be treating those patients aggressively.
Thank you for watching the video. If you like similar contents, please consider subscribing to my channel, share and like the video, and hit the notification bell so you will get updated. This is Dr. Erdi Fadrigilan, your Pinoy EP.